said a hip hop, the hip it, did a hip hip hop, you don't stop the rockin'.
Try telling that to the organisers of the Sydney Royal Easter Show, who earlier this week announced a rap ban.
There will be no music played that is rapper type music or has any swearing words through it or any offensive language.
The reason? To deter young criminal groups from attending after the stabbing death of a 17-year-old at last year's show.
We've implemented a whole heap of new measures for this year's show. We've increased the lighting. We've ensured the carnival closes at 9:30 every night. We've doubled our police presence. And, of course, the level of the music will be brought down as well.
The Comanchero bikie gang last year particularly and proactively recruited youth through rapper music. Rapper music is being used to lure youth into a life of crime.
The music community is calling BS.
There's no evidence that backs that up whatsoever. It's ridiculous to say that hip-hop music has any role to play in actually recruiting people to join organised crime or bikie gangs. It has no basis in any kind of logic.
We do see regularly police coming out and essentially saying these rap lyrics or these rap songs are a way of recruiting gang members, and that's completely unfair. These artists that are coming out are literally only telling a story of what they've been through and their origins. It's simple as that.
Show organisers today backtracking after the backlash, claiming it's not a ban and it's not just rap music that's on the no playlist.
We haven't targeted one particular group of music. Rap music was something that was mentioned, but we've carried that right throughout all styles of music.
That explanation not enough for artists who say this is censorship.
One of the things I love about hip-hop music is there is a voice that is amplified from communities that traditionally are not heard. And this is taking that voice away.
They're kind of setting an agenda here to say that rap music will cause violence, which is absurd.
So have Easter show organisers gone too far? And does this mean some good Enya fun on the ghost train this year?
Very different ride.
Very different.
Well, I'm really worried about this, though, if this rapper music is leading to crime. Because
rapper music.
Well, I play rapper music, like, in my comedy festival shows, like, for 20 minutes before the show, and I don't... Maybe I'm losing a lot of my audience to stabbings.
Yeah. You would never know, would you, either?
I wouldn't know. Like, I mean, they're all getting carted out before I come in.
I don't know. I don't know how real it is. Like, rap music doesn't want to make me stab anyone, but I've listened to Nickelback and I get pretty angry. So
a bit stabby with Nickelback?
Potentially, yeah. I don't know, but this won't change anything. The type of music doesn't.
We used to have this argument about heavy metal, didn't we?
Yeah.
The same sort of thing.
Well, rock and roll, it's kind of...
I would just say to all the parties involved, you've just got to stop, collaborate and listen. You know?
Wait, what's that? Sorry, Wally. It actually does work. Oh, my God.
Can I say, as a Queen fan, I'm deeply offended by...
I know, you're under pressure.